Welcome to Activate Your Introvert, the podcast for intrapreneurs and business leaders to help unlock more productivity and creativity so you get a better business. In this week's episode, we're looking at noise, because I've been told that noise at the moment is low, and that's another reason for it being time of the introvert. Well, I actually don't believe that. Have you been on social media lately? So I'll be joined briefly by speaker Ben Abdi Collins for his views on social noise, and Christina Jones, who owns a digital marketing agency, for comments on social noise. Then Christina's going to go on from there to talk about how business owners at the moment could be making use of Facebook ads and why that could be a very relevant technique for them. Before I come back to this noise theme to think about how it could be time of the introvert because of the way people are talking a lot in meetings and how that could be helping introverts to step forward. If you'd like to talk to me about issues raised in this podcast or others relating to introverts, please visit introvertinbusiness.co.uk. Introverts don't like noise. I don't know that I completely buy into that. However, research that I've done does say that more introverts dislike lots of random noise than non-introverts. So there is an element to that. I don't think it's a definitional element, clearly, because there's a number of extroverts who don't like noise either. But here's my explanation of it. Introverts get tired when they are socializing a lot, and that's a definitional point of being an introvert. And I suspect that the noise that's around, especially when it's random and randomly loud noise from sources people don't know, is tiring in a similar way to spending a lot of time socializing. So I think there is some sense into that, but certainly, as I said, I do know a number of introverts who typically don't like noise and get exhausted by it. Sometimes that's combined with the noise at a conference. So there's a lot of socializing going on in the conference, as well as a lot of noise. Double whammy for a number of introverts. So on that basis, it makes sense to say now is the time of the introvert, because working from home means everything is quieter. Except, I don't know if you've seen it, but certainly I've seen a huge upturn in the amount of noise on social media. Not just more postings, but more postings with more ego in them, proclaiming that so-and-so can sort out the world. Now, I wasn't sure if I was the only one that was seeing this, so I was chatting to Ben Abdi Collins. Ben is a fellow speaker, a member of the Professional Speaking Association, and we will be hearing some more from Ben in a podcast in a few weeks' time. So I asked Ben about this noise. Ben, a couple of minutes ago, we were talking about noise. And of course, noise is something that affects introverts, which really interested to hear your views on. But more particularly, we were talking about how noise on social media has changed, shall we say, in the last couple of weeks since many more people have been working from home.
I've noticed there's been a huge wave of people going, well, I can't go anywhere else, so I might as well go on social media. Some people are genuinely seeming to want to help. Some people are just genuinely broadcasting. I find that personally kind of frustrating. I don't like being talked at in life, and on social media being talked at is incredibly frustrating. If someone feels they need to prove to me that they're clever, they're already proving to me that they're not. That seems like an irony to me. I believe personally that we need to lead each other into conversation, that we need to lead each other into feeling secure and safe in conversation, whether in life, in face-to-face, or on social media, because social media is just a platform for an opportunity to be able to communicate. And it actually almost amplifies our behaviors.
And so, whilst you're going on to LinkedIn, which is where people find you the most,
I'm looking for the people who are putting out considered, level, kind, humorous, understanding types of posts, posts that help people to begin to get a sense of themselves or what they're dealing with or how to deal with it more effectively or to feel supported.
How do you as an introvert feel when there's all this noise going on where people are shouting?
I basically ignore them because I don't think it's appropriate. I don't think it proves anything other than that possibly is your MO.
So, the noise on social media, certainly from my perspective, certainly from Ben's, is something which has increased. And we, and certainly other introverts I've spoken to, don't like it. Of course, you then get to the point where you say, but how am I going to promote my business on social media? And does this noise really exist? Is this my imagination? Is this Ben's imagination? So the next thing I did was to ask Christina Jones. Christina runs a digital ma marketing agency, so she knows a lot about the science behind this. One of the things that I've seen lately, we're sitting, what, 2 weeks into the lockdown of coronavirus. I've seen, or I think I've seen, a lot more social media noise. Am I right with that? And what's going on there?
Oh, so much. And not just noise, but really quite aggressive negativity as well. So people being trolled, people taking a pop at them, putting comments on. And that's because social media use is through the roof at the moment. And there's a lot of people who are really stressed, really miserable, really bored. And they're not acting how they normally would. So it's, I'm trying to advise people that it's never normally about what you're saying. They may be really stressed because their grandmother is in hospital right now, and their stress relief for that is by being a bit of a idiot on
On social
Instagram.
media. Okay. So from an introvert perspective, I've got two reactions. One is I see this noise, and my first thought is, fine, I'll just ignore it and walk away from it. But as a business owner, I know that's not necessarily the right thing to do. What would you suggest introverted business owners do at the moment while this extra hostility and noise is online?
One, have a really good support group around you. So I'm in a mastermind. I've got close friends who are entrepreneurs as well. So if you're feeling a bit down in the dumps because someone's had a real pop at you, you can discuss it with someone else instead of taking it out of you, living in your brain. And the second thing, though, is golden opportunity right now that there's more attention online than there's ever been. So you need to be there taking advantage of it. But for me, as someone who's introverted, I'm pretty disciplined about the time I spend and the tools I use. So I pre-schedule a lot of my social media. And even if I'm not working that far in advance, because right now I think it's dangerous to be planning several weeks in advance because situation is changing so quickly. But it means that I'm uploading all my content in a bit of a vacuum. So I'm not having to see the news feeds. I'm not even having to see messages and comments while I'm in create mode. And then twice a day, I've got some blocks in my diary that I go in and respond to comments and messages.
One of the things I've seen is if social media use has gone through the roof at the moment, how then should I or any other introvert or extrovert, to be honest, be heard? Because if all the noise is there, is there a way of still punching through some of that to be heard?
I'm going to shamelessly plug Facebook ads here or any sort of online advertising. But the reason why is that the costs for Facebook ads in particular are the lowest they have been for 2 or 3 years. So people who are advertising at the moment are getting in front of 3 or 4 times as many people for every £10 they spend than they would have been back in January. If it's something that you're have been thinking of doing, now is probably the best value for money time to do it. And it also means that you can, it's a little bit of an easier route. You don't have to spend hours pushing your organic social media. You can say, I'm going to put some good content out there and I'm going to put £3-5 a day behind it. And then I'm going to go and sit in my garden and enjoy the sunshine and not worry about spending an hour engaging and following other people to try and get more organic reach.
And is the Facebook advertising that much cheaper at the moment because of what's going on, or is there some other reason?
Two main reasons. One is that certainly the travel industry have pulled their ads everywhere. Facebook and Google haven't given any official numbers about this, but ITV were really transparent, even back in early March, saying that they would be 10% down in ad revenue in April, purely from travel companies pulling TV ads.
Wow.
So there's less competition, like there's less advertisers, and there's also more ad inventory because people are, if someone's been on social media on average for an hour a day, they may well be on there at the moment for 2 or 3 hours a day because they're at home, they're furloughed, or even if they're working from home, they're not working particularly hard. You've got to think of the mindset of employees. Mm.
So, tip of the week would appear to be, if you want to get seen on social media, it's a time to think about Facebook advertising. And whatever you're doing on social media at the moment, be aware of the noise that's out there and be aware of ways that you can contribute positively to it. Big, big thanks to Christina and Ben. Their contact details are in the sleeve notes for this episode. Now, I took the opportunity while I was discussing future episodes with them to take today's short clips. So thanks once again to Ben and Christina. But here's the final link, and it comes back to noise again, and something that Ben was touching on. At the moment, huge amounts of noise, and as Christina said, a lot of it generated because many, many people are very, very worried. Now, what's the impact of that in team meetings and team discussions? And what is one of the introvert skills that we could be putting into place right now? Introverts tend to be very good at perhaps summarizing, perhaps keeping things on track and not getting overly excited in meetings. Now could be a great opportunity for you as an introvert to be stepping up, volunteering to your boss to facilitate or run the virtual meetings in your team. Or flip that the other way around. You're managing a team, in that team are introverts. Now could be the time to draw on them to make your team meetings hugely better, because introverts have a different way and a different perspective on noise. So this could be a great time to think about that. Thank you for listening to Activate Your Introvert, and I hope you've enjoyed this week's episode. I'd love to see your reviews on the iTunes store. Thank you once again, and catch up with you next week.